So as we know, adjuvant chemotherapy that's given after curative intent surgery for stage 2 or 3 colon cancer can cure some of these patients, so improve their survival outcome. Unfortunately, we don't currently have a tool or a test that can detect these microscopic disease that's left after surgery. So instead, we use pathological risk features and pathological staging to infer a patient's recurrence risk after their surgery. And we know that using this approach is somewhat imprecise, leading to overtreatment of majority of patients. For example, in stage 2 colon cancer, over 80% of patients are actually cured by surgery alone, so they don't actually have microscopic residual disease that required further treatment. And importantly, we might be under-treating some of these patients. For example, if a patient are seen to have low-risk disease based on their clinical or pathological features, we may not be giving them adjuvant chemotherapy, and a small proportion of these patients will still recur. So we're under-treating some patients and over-treating a majority of patients. The dynamic study is a study designed in stage 2 colon cancer patients asking the question, can we use ctDNA blood test to guide treatment by compared to standard care of not using this test, and will that result in the less use of chemotherapy without compromising the risk of recurrence? So 455 patients was randomized in this study. In this study, patient with a positive test at 4 and 7 weeks after surgery were given chemotherapy, and those who had a negative test were spared chemotherapy. They were just surveyed or observed. We found that we almost halved the number of patients requiring chemotherapy. So we reduced the proportion of use of chemotherapy from 28% down to 15% by using the blood test alone, and without compromising the outcome. So the 2-year and 3-year recurrence-free survival in the study was very comparable. And some early preliminary data also suggests that over 80% of these patients converted their ctDNA from positive to negative after adjuvant chemotherapy, suggesting a very high proportion of this patient can be cured by adjuvant chemotherapy. I think there are probably two real areas of unmet need that I'm hoping future clinical trials can help to address over the next few years. The first is using ctDNA dynamics. So you're using serial changes of ctDNA over time, after surgery and then after adjuvant chemotherapy, to demonstrate and see whether adjuvant chemotherapy is effective or not. In particular, in patients where the ctDNA did not clear with chemotherapy, hopefully providing an opportunity, a small window opportunity, for us to intervene with a second chemotherapy or a novel therapy or a novel treatment to, you know, improve their chance of cure, because clearly standard treatment is failing them. We need to give them a better treatment option. The second area is to define the role of circulating tumor DNA or ctDNA in a surveillance setting, so in the monitoring setting. So let's say if someone's ctDNA rises during follow-up, what do we do with that result? Can we use ctDNA to complement or even replace our current standard of care of CEA or our routine imaging? And importantly, can we introduce therapy in the patient where we didn't see any imaging evidence of cancer, but we pick up ctDNA in the circulation? Can we intervene? So I think those are the two areas of unmet need that future clinical trials, and there are some ongoing actually, that will give us the answers.